Send it over to Rob Sharp now. Rob, it's a wild night in Tasmania. How extreme were those winds?
It was remarkable. Trees down all over the place on the west coast of Tassie, particularly around Strawn, where winds reached as high as 143 kilometres per hour. That broke the previous record wind of 130 kilometres an hour, and there's 40 years of data there, so that is pretty remarkable. Elsewhere, Matsuka Island, 178 kilometres per hour, so that's the equivalent of a Category 3 tropical cyclone, those kind of winds. So that's the strongest there for the very exposed island in 8 years. So some extreme winds across Tasmania there, and there's more to come. So there's the main front moving through, that line of wet weather early this morning. After that, we're on an easing trend, the showers and the wind dropping off, but there's that next front still to come. And the worst weather from that is due between 3 and 8pm for Tasmanians today. So prepare for another strong front that looks fairly similar to the one that's just moved through. Meanwhile, much of the rest of the country is enjoying much calmer conditions and doesn't have this huge severe weather warning for damaging destructive winds. We've got lovely sunny skies out through the east of Australia. And yesterday, Sydney got to 25 degrees. That is 8 above the average for Sydney-siders. And in Brisbane, it got to 26. But today is heading for 27 degrees. So the focus of the warmth is southern Queensland and northern New South Wales today. Sydney-siders, it's a little bit cooler than yesterday, but still way above the long-term average. And down through the south, a chance of a shower or two in Adelaide and a few showers up around Cairns as well.
Okay, Rob, thank you.